she take my money? Well, I'm in need. Yes, it's a trifling friend indeed. Oh, she's a gold digger. Way over town. That digs on me.
I ain't saying she a gold digger.
I'm in need.
She ain't messing with no broke niggas.
Kill me, mom.
I ain't saying she a gold digger.
I'm in need.
She ain't messing.
Emergency. I'll come over here, please. Hello, what's your emergency, ma'am?
My husband's gotten crazy again with me.
What's your address, ma'am? Okay, ma'am, and your name? Okay, one more time, ma'am. Okay, what city are you in, ma'am?
Fort Lauderdale.
Okay, and what do you mean your husband's gotten crazy with you again?
He's breaking things, he's just scaring me.
And where is he now?
Left the room because I called you. I don't know.
Okay, your husband's white, black, or Hispanic?
Black.
And his name? And the last name, I'm sorry? Okay, and are there any injuries, ma'am? Ma'am?
No.
You're not injured?
No.
And how long ago did this happen?
A minute ago.
I'm sorry, you said 1 minute?
Yeah.
And what color shirt is he wearing?
Blue.
A blue shirt? What color pants?
Yeah, I don't know.
And what part of the home are you in?
Master bedroom.
Master. Are there any weapons involved?
No.
Okay, ma'am. I will get the units out there for you, okay? They're en route. Hello?
Because if it's a matter to you.
By a Russian mail order bride. A local professor claims this happened to him.
Yeah, that's right. WMAO 2 News' Mallory Sipaste tells us how he loved, then lost thousands of dollars. Because if it's a matter to you, it's a matter for Mallory.
Dr. Jonathan Farley says there are misconceptions about mail order brides. He saw it as a way to meet women serious about marriage, and he thought he did. He met a woman in person, had a 3-year courtship, then married her. But now he says it was all a ploy. He estimates he lost $50,000 and is asking the federal government to look into it. An accomplished mathematician, Dr. Jonathan Farley looked at finding love like a statistics problem.
There are 10 million more women than men in Russia.
He liked his odds, so he traveled to Siberia where he met a woman in an unconventional way.
So I met her in 2013. I used a mail order bride website called elenasmodels.com. And even though they use the term mail order, no one actually arrives in the mail.
The website delivered. Jonathan met his match.
Alona Arturovna Dauksha.
She was 20. He was 42. Despite the age difference, they thought they'd give it a shot.
We stayed in touch. I sent her about 250 questions about family life, you know, how many kids would you want to have, other aspects, and she answered all of them.
He met her parents in Turkey. They dated for 3 years, then married at the Towson courthouse. in what was supposed to be the start of an exciting chapter soured quickly.
And then her behavior completely changed. The arguments and insults and the spending was incredible. So we went to places like Walmart and she would spend $400. We went to Bed Bath & Beyond. She spent $900. I don't remember how much we spent at IKEA.
He says the spending continued, as well as the insults, until he hit his breaking point 3 months into the marriage. Alona wanted a new coat. When Jonathan offered to go with her to make the purchase,
she said, "Give me the money, give me the money, give me the money, the $500. And this alarmed me so much that I realized I have to get out of there.
Again, he tried to reconcile, but the two agreed to sign a separation agreement. Jonathan bought her a plane ticket to Turkey and gave her $3,000 to start a new life.
And she told me something cryptic that she could have been much harder on me. I didn't think she could have been much harder. At one stage, I had a $12,000 credit card bill. I think I may have had two of them.
Jonathan didn't know what she meant until he went back to their apartment.
He still had a table and three chairs, but everything else had been taken.
He says she cleaned it out in 2 days. Looking at the empty room, it finally hit him.
All of her seemingly strange behavior then made perfect sense, that it was a scam from the very beginning, just to get the green card, just to spend as much of my money as possible. She had never intended for the marriage to work out.
He called police, petitioned the state's attorney. Both turned down his request to file theft charges. Under Maryland law, a spouse cannot steal from a cohabitating spouse. He messaged the FBI and U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services, but nothing came of it. He says Alona at one point even threatened him, implying she's affiliated with the Russian mafia. But maybe the biggest blow is that they still share a name.
I'm still married. to her. So 2.5 years later, I do feel really stupid, I have to admit, but I don't beat myself up because it was a good scam.
We spoke to his divorce attorney, who said it's taken some time to finalize the divorce because Alona's out of the country. They have a hearing scheduled next month, and we were able to reach Alona. She disputes what he told us and made some accusations we were unable to verify. Jonathan said he stopped using those kinds of dating sites and he's focused on math and self-improvement.
Pet names like Big Daddy, my husband.
Can't wait to be with you.
Funny, she makes me feel special. She is my soulmate. Maria and I communicate every single day. And she sends me these little videos, and she's given me pet names like Big Daddy, my husband.
Can't wait to be with you. Love you, my husband.
Do you think she's sending those videos to anyone else?
I hope she's not sending those videos to anyone else.
Did she ever say your name?
Love you, my baby.
Well, when she calls me my baby, that's what she calls me.
Baby, hi. I just want to tell you that I love you and I miss you.
So, we are finally going to get to meet in person. I'm planning to fly to Ukraine and I'm really excited.
How are things going with Maria?
It's going good. She has a good heart and she cares about me for me. And she wants to get married. Marie and I, we've been dating for 5 years, and we've been talking about marriage for a long time.
Why haven't you ever met her in person?
Well, because it's really hard for me to save up the money to do that. She's a receptionist. She's not getting paid that much, so I'm trying to at least help her and send her money.
Like a lot?
I give her probably about $800 a month. The American dollar goes a long way in Ukraine. She needs to buy clothes for herself. She needs to pay for the cable, internet. So every time I get a paycheck, I send her money. Over the years, I've sent $40,000 to Maria.
When are you going?
I'm gonna try to go in a couple of weeks.
It's just really fishy to me. I feel like she's feeding him lies. I don't wanna see him get hurt. He's a really nice guy.
I'm like overboard excited to go meet her. It's gonna be everything I dreamed of. Everything is riding on this. I've invested my savings, my time, working 7 days a week. It's got to work. I just feel in my blood that it's going to work. I just can't get her out of my mind.
Well, I hope it works out the way you hope it does.
Yep, I hope so too. When I tell people I do nails, they're pretty surprised. I learned to do nails from my ex-girlfriend. She was my high school sweetheart. We dated for 13 years, and when we broke up, I was heartbroken. But still a hopeless romantic. It's very important for me to have somebody that's my soulmate, somebody that I can walk the beach with, live our life, and basically in like a dreamland, like I love you. And I think I finally found the one woman that I've been searching for all my life. Her name is Maria. She's 28 years old, and she lives in Ukraine. We met on Anastasia Date. It's a very special website that brings Americans and Ukrainian women to meet each other for a small price. Anastasia Date has a unique system. You could buy flowers, candy. Then it's up to the girl whether she wants to respond. This is the card and the flowers that I sent her with my email and my phone number on it. This cost me $450. And then she emailed me back and there was immediate sparks. Yeah, it was like firecrackers and everything was just booming off. She's kind, she's smart, funny. She makes me feel special. She is my soulmate. Maria and I communicate every single day. And then she sends me these little videos and she's given me pet names like Big Daddy, my husband.
I can't wait to be with you. Love you, my husband.
Do you think she's sending those videos to anyone else?
I hope she's not sending those videos to anyone else. The past 5 years. Right now I'm starting to worry because this isn't the first time that I tried to meet up with Maria. Over the past 5 years, me and Maria, we tried to meet up over 3 different occasions. The first time, the travel agency, they took half of her money. The second time, she said that she missed the flight. The third time, she was missing something on her passport. I have no idea what it was. And I paid for everything. I just want to see her in real life, because that's a part of my life that I'm missing. Are you sure you don't want me to go to Ukraine? Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. It's better to do when it's nice weather.